Hi, I'm Dan Upshody here with Utility Keystone Trailer Sales. This is a part of our How to Buy the Best Flatbed video series. Today we're going to talk about beam ratings. We're going to dive into that right now. All right, so the beams on your flatbed are essentially the backbone of the trailer. It's going to connect your front approach plate, your suspension hangers in the rear, and all your cross members run through it, and it's that backbone that supports your payload on the trailer. So there's two different types of beams. You have your aluminum beam, which would come on an all aluminum trailer, which we have here in the front. In the background, it's a combination trailer with a steel beam. An all steel trailer has a steel beam as well. There's a couple differences with them. Typically on an all aluminum trailer, you're not going to have the cross braces that you see in the background on a combo trailer there. And all aluminum trailer has more of a arch in the beam or a camber. And as you load the trailer, it sort of levels out to an extent. And as you're going down the road, the trailer will flex up and down like that. Now with a combo trailer, there's not nearly as much of an arch in it. Steel doesn't deflect as much as aluminum, so it's a stronger material. And as that load is on there and you're going down the road, it sort of flexes back and forth through those cross braces, which applies the weight back to the beam itself. So which beam is right for you? A lot of that's going to depend on your application, whether you go with a steel beam or an aluminum beam. There's also different beam ratings, anywhere from 52,000 pounds up to 80,000 pounds, and that is determined over how much that can hold over a 4-foot section. So a lot of things go into which one to pick. Ahead of time, you want to keep in mind, the load that you're currently running, but also keep in mind the backhauls that you might have on the way back. You don't want to limit yourself with options with starting with the wrong backbone of your trailer. Speaking of backhauls, there are some things we can do on the front end to properly spec that trailer to not limit your options. So you might want to look at a coil package, and those are fully customizable. Typically a standard is 6 stub cross members through the trailer. Utility comes standard with tapered cross members and a 47,000 pound coil package on the 4000 AE. Your aluminums max, they're typically standard with 4 to 6 stub cross members. And you want to look at that and potentially even a heavier beam. So typical flatbed has a 52,000 pound beam. You might want to up that to a 60,000 pound beam. Even if that might affect your day-to-day hauling, it might benefit you in the future with a backhaul. And you're really only looking at about adding 300 pounds. So something to definitely keep in mind. There's a lot of other things we can look at. So if you want to give us a call, we could talk through that and make sure we get you the best flatbed that's going to last for you and provide you with a wide array of different loads that you can haul. So you're hauling a specialty load, whether it's a wide load, oversize, over length. There's a lot of things we can do on the spec side in order to make sure you're dealing with the right piece of equipment. So on a wide load, we'll look at some additional cross braces on the side of the trailer, extendable wide load lights that you can put in the front and the rear just to make sure you're safe and going down the road. With a long load, there's actual trailers that have extendable beams. And with that, you're able to haul anywhere from a 48-foot load up to an 80-foot load and bigger. There's a lot of different options you can look at with that. If it's a dedicated coil run, we can look at additional coil packages on the trailer. You don't need to limit yourself to just one. If they're not overly heavy coils, we could spec 2-3 coil loads or do a coil package the whole length of the trailer. So lots of options. If it is a specialty load that you're running, give us a call and we'll work through that with you. So this wraps up our video on beams and beam ratings. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and follow us for more educational content. I'm Dan Upshody, and we'll see you next time.